It's a word you've read or heard a thousand times. However, its meaning is slippery. Perhaps it's best to start with what a calorie isn't. Calories are not little gremlins that live in your food and make you fat. They are not attracted to you and not your thin neighbor. They do not depend on your circumstances. The calorie is simply a word we use to describe energy. The energy we put into our body through food and drink, and the energy we use to move, think, and breathe. Think of your car. You add gasoline so it can move you and your screaming kids. Gasoline is fuel or stored energy that cars use to work. We add gallons of fuel, but we could say we were adding calories instead. 1 gallon of fuel is the same as 31,000 calories. That would make fuel seem very cheap at 0.01 cents per calorie. But we would still have sticker shock when we only got 0.0006 miles per calorie. We cannot use gasoline as energy. Our energy comes from food and drink. We call the energy lurking in our food the calorie. This is where things get complicated. You see, gasoline is almost 100% energy. We eat and drink calories, but they come in different varieties and with a host of other nutrients, including water, fiber, vitamins, minerals, and other non-digestible species. Getting a little more specific, 1 gram of protein or carbohydrates have about 4 calories. 1 gram of alcohol has about 7 calories, and 1 gram of fat has 9 calories. Of course, we don't tell the server, "I'll have 40 grams of carbs, 20 grams of protein, and throw in a few grams of fat to go." We order foods and drinks that have an assortment of nutrients. That is why some foods are energy dense, high calorie, low volume, and other foods are nutrient rich, low calorie, high nutritional value. So what happens to all the energy we added at the buffet? We use energy when we sleep, lie on the couch, and surf the web. We use it to think, dream, and even when we turn off our brains and watch. We are never off. In a great irony, we use energy to take in energy, as it takes as much as 10% of our calories to digest food. Of course, we must move at some point. Standing, walking, lifting, movement of any kind requires energy. Exercise requires energy. The muscles we add when we exercise need energy. The calorie comes in very handy as a means of fueling our lives. But what happens if we don't use all the energy? Your car has a tank with limited storage. We don't have tanks. Or do we? We do. We have millions of them. We call them fat cells. Fat cells love storing energy. Even better, they aren't steel tanks with limited capacity. They are balloons who feel they look their best, expanded to their fullest. Let's get back to the calorie. Think of the calorie as stored energy, and the fat cell where we store the energy. If we take in more calories than we use, we store the excess in fat cells. As our energy storage increases, our fat cells grow, and we gain weight. Our increased girth means we are ready for the next famine. Of course, the food desert is actually a dessert, and the stored energy seems to only grow and never recede. So the next time you think of the calorie, think of stored energy. Think of your insatiable fat cells with open doors, hoping to store more. But don't blame the calorie for your excesses. It does not have a personality. It does not have a personal preference. It is simply a description of the energy you eat and drink and the energy you use to live. What happens to the energy is up to you.